Hey dudes, Neil here. Coffee Fiends is back, and just in time for the Joseph update hitting Albion September 27th, 2017. And this is an exciting moment for all of us Albionites. Joseph isn't a bunch of hotfixes or balances. It's a real post-release content update. That means more stuff to do. Let's do a quick rundown of what's in store. First off, new abilities. I really didn't see this coming so soon. Weapons like bows, daggers, curse staves, swords, and spears are getting a handful of new abilities starting at tier 5. An example of one of these new abilities is Ray of Light for the bow, which roots enemies when a giant arrow you summon makes contact with your foe. Daggers get a more rogue, thief-like ability called Shadow Edge, which, when it hits a target, will root them for a period of time, then teleport you to their location, so you can unload all that dagger goodness into your enemies at lightning speed. The abilities overall are starting to look more unique for each weapon type, and I'm into it. The Relic Locker chests are getting a rework and are being replaced with treasure sites. But this isn't just a name change for the same content, no sir. We're talking a total rework. There's the same relic locker you'd find originally in the center of the area, but scattered around it will be literal piles of silver, and items you can bust open for even more silver. Busting open some of these items will spawn mobs, dropping even more silver. There's definitely a reason to visit these sites now, even if the lockers aren't spawned. This is going to lead to more PvP encounters with other players, because we'll still be flagged in the area like the older relic locker system. This is new, this is different, and that's good. I can't wait to get ganked trying to get those fat stacks, dog. Ooh. Let's talk the majorly needed smart casting. Abilities you had to throw in a direction or place down were a little difficult to place quickly, efficiently, and accurately. I can't tell you how many wind walls I've accidentally placed behind me instead of in front of me. Albion is adding two new options: quick cast on button press and quick cast on button release. These should point spells in the direction of your cursor as well, helping players aim spells where they need to go and get them out quickly. The original casting settings will be the default. You'll be able to change to the smart casting by going to Settings, Game Settings, and Mouse Control. I saved the best ones for last. My personal favorite, Arenas. Finally, some structured PvP for casual players. Players who just aren't dedicated enough to get a guild together, or can't find the time to participate in guild versus guild. This is what I want. You queue up with your team of 5, you'll be ported to an MMO-style PvP map where you'll fight for control points, earn tokens to turn in for sick rewards like sexy mounts and other vanity-esque items. This is good. I am supes excited. We aren't sure if you're able to queue by yourself without a team yet, but I'm sure we will find out soon. Some brand new expeditions have been added to the roster, but I'm sure new boss mob mechanics and difficulties will accompany them as well. I love the expedition system with the simple drop-in, drop-out playstyle with little risk, and I can always consume some content even if I only have a minute to play. They're even adding little tidbits of lore in these new expeditions. Did you guys know there's a Albion book? There's a digital book. I'm gonna read it. I am a total lore whore. Anyway, more expedition variety is a good thing. Both arenas and expeditions are going to help put Albion on a new level in terms of MMOs. The big turnoff for a lot of people when I spread the good word of Albion is it sounds like a game I have to dedicate a lot of time into if I want to enjoy it. They're right. You have to dedicate a lot of time right now to enjoy the game. If you want to PvP, you have to grind a fair amount of silver and fame to even stand a chance in hostile areas. And there is a lot on the line in terms of losing your gear you worked so hard to craft or purchase. The same goes for dungeons and open world. All it takes is a massive guild to steamroll you on the way to their objective. And then everything you've done feels meaningless because you're not returning with your spoils of war. But with more hop-in, hop-out structured content, like arenas and expeditions, and the safety of cities, people can consume content, feel they've progressed a little bit, and only have to spend 30 minutes doing so. Albion appeals to a nostalgic, mature audience. Time is a valuable thing to adult MMO players. We don't have a lot of it these days. Sandbox Interactive is ensuring players like us that we have time to play Albion. And that's cool that they're adding more content for the casual audience. It was a smart move and I'm confident it's going to pay off. There will be a bunch of little changes as well, like UI improvements so everything's pretty, abilities are getting new casting animations to make them stand out more, the cast time to exit dungeons is getting shortened, thank Morgana for that one, expeditions are getting a gear cap so OP players can't bulldoze their way through them, some bosses are getting rebalanced, etc. We'll do a detailed video on all of this stuff when we get the official notes. But until then, let us know what you think of the changes in the comments. We love getting opinions from the player based on upcoming changes. Is this a good direction? Is it a bad direction? Do you guys want Albion to be a little more casual? Or should the game stay time-consuming and unforgiving? Until then, I'm Neil, aka Fiends, and I'll see you guys in Martlock. Oh, by the way, we live in Martlock. So say hello next time you try to gank me on my way to Caerleon. See you later, guys.